album. My name is Rick Estrin. I've been playing the harmonica for probably, I'm not that good at math, but maybe over 45 years probably. My older sister had some Jimmy Reed records, and I heard that, and I started here. She had some other blues records, and I was just a peculiar kid, and to me that stuff just spoke to me. When other kids were listening to whatever the popular music of the day was, the Beatles or something like that, I got something about that music really sent a message to me, and it made me feel like I understood how those, in my imagination, I understood how those people felt. I probably didn't, but I thought I did, at the time. So, and I just pursued it. It was just a journey of a young kid just bumbling through life, man. But that harmonica was always there, I did a lot of crazy things and a lot of stupid things, but that harmonica was always there, and that harmonica really, really saved me from a lot of my own stupidity, gave me a focus, and gave me something I could feel proud of, and something I could get some positive feedback from other people about.
I'm calling all fools. Calling all fools like me. Yeah, I'm calling all fools. Calling all fools like me. If you ever been a sucker, brother, you got company.
One time, I only met Sonny Terry once, and I was with another guy who was a friend of his. And he said, if you're good to that harmonica will take care of you too, Hopefully I'm carrying enough of it on that maybe somebody else will pick it up when I'm gone. I'm not trying to revolutionize anything, but I'm trying to express my own feelings in that tradition. I think it's a beautiful, noble tradition, and I hope I can do it justice at least part of the time. Well, Jimmy Reed was probably the first influence because he was the first guy I heard. After that, I heard John Lee Williamson, and then I heard Rice Miller, and I thought they were the same guy, so I didn't. As I listened and I learned, I got into, both Sonny Boys. I got into Little Walter, and James Cotton was a guy I got to see a lot. I got to actually see him a lot and be around him a little bit and get to know him. Junior Wells, I saw. Many times, and got to know these guys a little bit too. I moved to Chicago when I was about 20 years old and lived there for a period of time. I kept going back and forth from California to Chicago. Played with many great blues artists back there, and it was still. There was still a lot of that going on. It wasn't a clinical study like it would have to be now. It was you could actually participate in the real deal was still, the real things were still around. And I sat in with Muddy Waters when he still had a process and was standing up all night, and on the south side of Chicago at the Sutherland Hotel. So that I'm old enough where I was still able to do things like that and take advantage of that opportunity. pursue that. Jay Hansen, the drummer, he's been with me probably 12 years. He was there with Little Charlie. Lorenzo Farrell, who plays bass and organ, he's been with us like 10 or 11 years. And Kit Anderson, who is the new guy, he's been with us now 6 years. And it's just a, you know, we're all friends. And we have a, you know, a great time together, and we have a, like our own little culture. I think it became maybe more of a group effort. For years it was Charlie and me, and who were the bass player and drummer were, we would have guys for years, you know, but they were strictly accompanists, and they really had no input into what we did, you know, and it was. And now I think it's a, maybe it's a more interactive group where everybody, it's like more like a team rather than two guys backing up two other guys. So it's we have a lot of fun, and I think it's a great band, and it's really nice for me at my age to finally see that you can have something like that. You can have a band where, gee, everybody's like friends and gets along, and there's nobody that, you know. Normally, I'll just, you know, I'll write songs, and I'll write them on the guitar, and come up with a some kind of a bass line or a recurring figure on the guitar, and come up with the, you know, the lyrics and the melody and whatever, and work on that and bring it into the band, or maybe just to Kid first, with the guitar player first. And they'll, he'll flesh it out, make it not quite so. I'm a very primitive guitar player, so he'll improve on it, or, you know, ask me if I like this or that, you know, some treatment for it, and we'll get something, and then we'll go rehearse with the other two guys, and they'll come up with their parts, and, you know, I'll give them an idea what I think it should be, and they'll do something that improves on that.
But you keep coming back for more. Yeah, gonna give it one more shot. Give it everything you got. You're just the kind of chump we're looking for. I'm calling all fools. All fools like me.
I've been nominated for all kinds of stuff. One time I won for songwriter, for song of the year, and this last year I won for harmonica. So that was nice. We've been nominated. We were nominated for band of the year many times. I was nominated for entertainer of the year a couple of times, and different Kid was nominated for guitar player this last time. So yeah, it's nice, and it's similar to this event in a way, because you go there to Memphis, and you know that's when you see your friends, you know, all the different people that are in our little microcosmic world of playing blues in the 21st century.
Yeah, I'm calling all fools, calling all fools like me. Yes, if you ever been a sucker, He got company. You 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 got company.
You can't see anything that's occurring. Really, it's, you know, if you watch somebody play the guitar, you can see what they're doing, but a harmonica is a blind man's instrument in a way. So, man, I probably shouldn't even say this, but I will. Okay, I had the idea for the title. I thought this would be a good title. This will be, people will buy this, man, because nobody really wants to do the work. They just want to know the secret. So I called it, you know, Rick Estrin Reveals Secrets, Subtleties, and Tricks of the Blues Harmonica. But I really had no content for it. I knew I wanted to put several attractive models in there. And I had an idea for how it would begin. You know, I had an idea that, you know, I would have somebody that couldn't play very good, but was really had, you know, a harmonica can sound really annoying if somebody doesn't know what they're doing, right? I mean, I hate to say that, but it's true. So I had a guy looked like a kind of a homeless guy standing there, you know, squeaking on the harmonica, and I don't want to should get the DVD. Whoever's watching this, get it. But so I did what every real harmonica player has wanted to do at some time or another. I'm not going to say what it is, but it was people cheered when I did it. I we put a little teaser on YouTube of that, and Paul Osher called me and left me a message, and he could barely talk. He was laughing so hard, and I called him back, and I went, "Oh, Paul, man, I'm glad you liked that." And I go, "Oh, man, I'll send you one." And he goes, "No, I already bought one." On the serious side, I think that I address a lot of conceptual things about playing blues on the harmonica that are not typically taught that I've seen, and I've never had one complaint. All I've had is people love it, and that really is gratifying to me. And I hope that doesn't sound arrogant, but it's just, that's the honest to God truth, man. People love that DVD. Well, hopefully you can expect more. I'll write some more songs, and I'll put out some more CDs, and hopefully the best is yet to come. I'm enjoying this life more now than ever before. I'm so grateful, and I feel so fortunate to be able to do things like this and to go all over, you know, to go all over the world and make people happy, hopefully. And that's, you can't beat that, man. It's a great life, and I'm a lucky guy to be able to do that. Make people happy with HOHNER harmonicas.